growing up, Superman was always my favorite childhood hero.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm a little more cultured by superheroes. Personally, I preferred the Monkey King. The company of Monk on his quest to go to India to translate the scrolls.
I remember that guy. Legend has it, he was fertilized when heaven and earth had an encounter. Bet that was some affair, huh? So, like all children of deities, he had special powers. And it wasn't long before he became a master martial artist. He could change into 72 forms and shapes. And he could also pull hair from his neck, blow on it, and turn it into a magical wand or an army of other little monkeys. But he was so powerful that he was also mischievous, and he always liked to play pranks on the gods. Well, the gods didn't like to be made fools of, so they allied together to capture the Monkey King. They threw him into a hot oven to try to burn him, but the Monkey King, always clever, found some special medicine. He drank it and became even more powerful.
Yeah, but you know, that Monkey King guy, he wasn't all bad. I mean, he was a hero after all. So, you know, after he got tired of messing around, you know, after about being 1,000 years old, and also about after he was imprisoned under a mountain for 500 years, he turned into a good guy when the Goddess of Mercy asked him to accompany this monk on his travels to India. He protected the monk. After that, no one heard from him. It's been hundreds of years. But rumor has it that tonight he's coming to Case. That's right, to Triple A Show. Only for us. And he's gonna help the Kung Fu Club put on an awesome demonstration. But beware, I heard there's a dark monk lurking in the shadows somewhere. Who knows what he's gonna do? All right, I'll see you guys after the show. Thanks.